and welcome to NIJ. I'm Avantika and currently we are in Ames. Right now behind me you can see there is a protest going on. This protest is basically being led by RDA. RDA is Resident Doctors Association. They are very angry about what happened in Kolkata, West Bengal, about the rape and murder of a lady doctor, of the resident doctor. So let us just talk to these protesters, these doctors here, and try to understand what exactly they feel about the situation, what exactly they have to say about the situation.
In light of this sad event, we want to highlight the lapses in security of doctors. There are so many crimes happening against doctors. The unsafe environment that we are working in. We were COVID warriors 4 years back. I don't know, we are demanding for basic safety now.
The fall, it has been delayed a lot. The day first, initially it was told that it was a suicide. Then it was told it was a murder. Then it was told it was rape and a murder. It's been already, 7 days and nothing sprouting, nothing fruitful has come out of the investigation done by the Kolkata police. Already the destruction and the reconstruction of the room where actually the murder had taken place has been started, which is not allowed actually. Which should not have been allowed by the police altogether. That is tampering of evidence. And then the CBI is coming up and taking up the case. So we think it has been delayed and the justice which should have been done earlier only is delayed altogether. Plus, I don't know if it is a Chinese whisper or it is true, the things are coming up like that. It's a big racket which is to be opened and many people from the higher official are involved. So now since the justice has to, like the thing which the investigation has been delayed, so the what exact thing which will come out of it, we don't know. So we are not very sure what has happened there, what actually has happened there, what has been shown by the people of higher authority, why principal was still onto the post and then he was given a higher post rather than removing. And even the court has said he should be given holiday rather than removing him from the post, though in his presence everything has been happened. In a hostel, but a girl was murdered and then it was proven that it was a suicide initially, and then later what happened I'm not very sure, but this has happened in West Bengal previously also. Then once it has happened, that CBI was not allowed to enter the Kolkata city itself from the airport for a particular case which has happened. So now we have to see what happens in future. But I'm very sure that things might not come out as pure as it was.
Entire incident that has happened, it needs a fair investigation and we are happy that CBI has been called in. But we have to prevent such incidences in future. What is the guarantee that all the doctors in other colleges are safe? There has to be a fear that committing such a crime against a doctor is a big offense.
Actually, if we see from the day one, they declared that it was a suicide. Then when the local team, local doctors protested, then only they sent the body for PM and lodged a FIR, then complaints. Then if we see the interview of the parents when they came to hospital, they were not allowed to see the patient. They were not allowed to meet with the body. And once they saw the body, it was in a horrendous condition. The body was bleeding from eyes, from private parts, the legs were twisted like someone was forcefully. So all these incidences pointed toward a bigger picture. But the picture painted by the police was it was a suicide. And then they said it was some psychological issue, that's why it happened. So from the day one, it seems that these all things have been, they are trying to protect someone. You know? They are watching the investigations. They are letting the real criminals get away. The CCTV footages which have come in picture, they are being circulated on various social media platforms. The various messages are there. All those are indicative of that these things have been happening from 11 p.m. onwards. But the actual time that the police is saying is between 3 to 4 a.m. So all this is not correlating with each other. So we are quite sure that there is something bigger in this. And the whole system is trying to protect someone who is of big picture. So that's why our protest, that's why we are continuing. And we will continue till our demands are met, till the culprits are punished. And before doctor, she was a doctor, she was a child, she was near and dear to someone. So this case needs to be taken by each and every one, common man also, like the same that was taken like in the Nirbhaya case, and this is not a less serious case. So we want to portray it that way and we want to fight for the long-term goals for Central Protection Act. We are all together, all the Resident Association of India are fighting for each other and we fight till we get it.
We are protesting for quick justice for the victim, and on top of that we want to have assurances regarding safety and security for doctors in their workplace. So that's why we are protesting. We have stopped all elective procedures, OPDs. But we have ensured that no patient who is critically ill or sick is denied treatment. So our emergency services are going on. Like our colleagues are functioning in the emergency departments, taking care of our patients. Meanwhile, we have stopped the elective procedures and we are protesting so that our rights are heard and met by the government.
So well, those were the voices of the resident doctors from the hospital AIIMS. And as you heard, as you saw them speak, they are highly concerned about this entire situation which took place in Kolkata, West Bengal. They want all the doctors to be safe, and that is why they are protesting here. So that's it for today's video. Take care. We'll see you again.